Stradlater is, quote, madly in love with himself. There's that word mad again. Comes up quite a bit in Catcher in the Rye. And then Holden makes the point that if somebody's real crazy about themselves, they assume that everyone else is crazy about them too. Holden, although he did stick up for Stradlater talking to Ackley, now does not seem to be such a fan. They start talking, and as Holden says, they start horsing around. Holden gets him in kind of this wrestling hold, and Stradlater breaks out of it. Holden actually says, "He was a very strong guy. I'm a very weak guy." Now, as a reader, what do you make of that? Physically, of course, it seems to be true. Stradlater's bigger, he's more athletic, Holden is kind of scrawny, he smokes a lot, so he has no wind, talks about that several times. But is it just the physical part that he's talking about? In the game of life, Stradlater seems to be a better player. That doesn't necessarily mean he's a better person. He's just able to be more successful. Does that make him stronger? And Holden, since he seems to be so caught up in analyzing everything and everything really drives him crazy and makes him feel depressed, is he weaker emotionally, mentally, socially? Stradlater finally admits that he's going on a date with Jean Gallagher. Holden corrects him. It's Jane Gallagher. Now, Jane Gallagher happens to be somebody that Holden cares a lot about. And he's not too happy that Stradlater wants to date her, because Holden does not trust Stradlater's intentions. It's right there that Holden does to Stradlater something similar to what Ackley did to Holden that Holden complained about in the previous chapter. Holden blocks Stradlater's light. Reality is, he was standing in his light casting a shadow. Stradlater couldn't see what he was doing. But can you look at that from another angle? Is there a metaphor in that? Stradlater's looking to go out on this date with Jane Gallagher. Holden is very upset about what Stradlater intends to do. Stradlater. Do I have to spell it out? Now, Holden remembers fondly a time when he and Jane were younger and they would play checkers together, and how Jane had this habit of always keeping her kings in the back row, which Holden found to be quite adorable. Stradlater is not at all interested in Jane Gallagher's checker playing skills, or in her habits of how she plays the game of checkers. But if life is a game, you see. Oh, wow, you don't get it? Holden really enjoyed playing the game of checkers with Jane. But the game of life, we will soon see, Holden's not so good at playing. Stradlater, not at all interested in the game of checkers, but in the game of life, he's kind of one of the hot shots that Holden says is one of those kinds of guys for whom it's good that life is a game. But Holden is very worried, because if life is a game, he doesn't want his friend Jane to be used like a pawn by Stradlater. Now, Holden goes on to talk about the things that he knows about Jane. She kept the kings in the back row. Stradlater's not interested. She had a lousy childhood. Stradlater ain't interested in that either. Holden says, "You know, I should really go say hi to Jane." Stradlater actually says, "Well, why don't you go instead of just standing around talking about it?" Because that's what Stradlater would do. Play the game of life, not just think about it. But Holden doesn't go. And throughout the rest of the story, keep track of the number of times Holden thinks about or even considers contacting Jane Gallagher, but doesn't do it. After Stradlater goes on his date, Holden doesn't know what to do with himself. He's sitting very nervously in a chair, and the way he describes it, it kind of makes you, the reader, wonder, you know, is Holden just being protective in a brotherly, friendly way, or is he jealous because he would like to have a date with Jane Gallagher, but he doesn't have the kind of confidence and assertiveness that Stradlater seems to have. Stradlater plays the game. Holden stands back from the game, and he can't even be a manager. We'll get to the next part of the story soon. Until then, salute.